In this video, we present to you all the important archangels and angelic choirs and their meanings for your spiritual work as well as your spiritual development. We also present to you the assignments of all angels on the Kabbalistic Tree of Life, so that you can get to know and connect their origins and meanings. This is, so to speak, the all-purpose overview of angels. At the end of this video, we will also give two specific examples for applications of this knowledge about angels and archangels. So you can already be curious. We will start immediately. Brotherhood of the Eternal Light, teaching the Western mysteries. Kabbalistic mysteries, meanings and assignments of the archangels and angels on the Kabbalistic Tree of Life. The Tree of Life is a kind of symbolic map, similar to a mandala, and forms the heart of Kabbalah. It is both the representation of the basic principles of the universe, that is, the macrocosm, as well as of the human soul, or microcosm. The Tree of Life also represents the process of creation, as well as the process of spiritual development. The following information about the archangels and angels partly originate from our video series about the Sefirot on the Tree of Life. Therein you will also find detailed descriptions of each Sefirah on the Tree of Life. If you have not already done so, check out our introductory video about the Tree of Life and its basic principles, the Sefirot. Please find the link in the description. Now let us take a closer look at the archangels and angelic choirs in relation to each Sefirah. Hereby you will get a complete overview of the angels for all basic spiritual topics. With this all-purpose overview of angels, you are well equipped for your practical work and your experiences with angels. Keter is the first Sefirah. Keter means crown, because Keter is the crown of existence. Keter represents the all-oneness, the divine, beyond duality. The archangel of Keter is Metatron, the prince of the countenance. Traditionally, he is the highest of the angels who stands face to face with God and serves him. Metatron was once a human being, the biblical prophet Enoch or Hanoch, who completed an entire life cycle of complete soul development, described in the Bible as a symbolic age of 365 years. At the end of his days, he did not die, but left a cycle of rebirth, being taken away by God and transformed into the archangel Metatron. The angels of Keter are the Chayot HaKodesh, that means the holy beings. These four sacred angelic beings carry the throne of God in the vision of the biblical prophet Ezekiel. They are considered the highest angels with only Metatron above them. Chochmah is the second Sefirah. Chochmah means wisdom, because in Chochmah the will of God manifests as a divine plan. Chochmah is the active divine principle of the fatherly creative power. The archangel of Chochmah is Raziel, will of God. Raziel corresponds to the divine plan that is the basis of creation. Since the ending El means my is God, whereby El means God and the suffix I means my, Raziel could also be translated as my will is God. The archangel Raziel is also assigned to Chochmah. Raziel means mystery of God or my secret is God. Raziel embodies the mystery of creation, a mystery which man cannot fully comprehend. The angels of Chochmah are the Ofanim, the wheels. They correspond to those wheels described in the vision of Ezekiel below the Chayot HaKodesh on the throne chariot of God. The Ofanim, that is, the wheels, stand for the principle of motion and thus correspond to the principle of force. Binah is a third Sefirah. Binah means understanding or insight, because in Binah wisdom becomes certainty. In Binah, the higher soul understands the meaning of destiny. Binah is the passive divine principle of the maternal receptive form. The archangel of Binah is Zafkiel or Zafkiel, which means contemplation of God or my contemplation is God. His task is to behold the divine plan. He receives it passively and monitors its execution with understanding. In addition, Zafkiel watches us humans and our souls and records our deeds. Accordingly, he represents the law of karma. The angels of Binah are the Erelim, which can be translated as altars of God. Just as the altar in the temple is the place of the manifestation of the divine, the Erelim are the angels responsible for the manifestation of divine power. Dat represents an important transformative principle on the Tree of Life. Dat is not always referred to as a Sephirah, and is sometimes called Invisible Sephirah. Dat means gnosis because Dat is the transformation point in which the vibrational frequencies of the higher principles transform themselves so that they can be recognized by human consciousness. Uriel is regarded as the archangel of Dat. Uriel means light of God or fire of God, or even my light is God or my fire is God. The symbolism of light is appropriate, considering the function of Dat as a transformation point in which the higher vibrational frequencies are recognized and understood by human consciousness. In the truest sense of the word, a light dawns on man. Assigning Uriel to Dat is also suitable because it is the orientation of the mystery student to the higher light which allows him to cross the abyss. Uriel is also the guide who has accompanied Hanoch on his journey through heaven and hell. The angels of Dat are the Irin, guardians, also called Grigori. Their function is to watch over people. Chesed is the fourth Sephirah. Chesed means grace, goodness, or love, for Chesed is the benevolent, growth-giving and constructive principle. Chesed is the benevolent, law-giving principle that enables a righteous order. The archangel of Chesed is Zadkiel, which means righteousness of God or my righteousness is God. This archangel helps people to lead a righteous life. The choir of angels of Chesed are the Chashmalim, the glittering or luminous ones. These benevolent angels have the task of carrying out the divine blessings. Gevurah is the fifth Sephirah. Gevurah means force or power, because in Gevurah lies the principle of assertiveness. Gevurah is the executive power that overcomes evil with just severity. The archangel of Gevurah is called Chamael, which means heat of God or wrath of God. Chamael is the archangel responsible for executing divine punishment and karma. He should not be called upon recklessly, but only with a pure heart. The angelic choir of Gevurah are the Seraphim, meaning the burning ones. They execute Chamael's orders. The Seraphim are often symbolized in the form of fire and sulfur in the Bible. Tiferet is the sixth Sephirah. Tiferet means beauty because Tiferet is the principle of balanced harmony. For in Tiferet, pure consciousness balances out the polarities. The archangel of Tiferet is Raphael. The meaning of Raphael is healer of God. Raphael is the archangel of healing and patron of refuah as taught by Salomo Baal Shem, the system of spiritual healing based on the teachings and principles of the Holy Kabbalah. You find the topic of spiritual healing interesting? Great! Because we will tell you more about refuah later in the video. The angels of Tiferet are the Malachim, meaning messenger or simply angel. The Malachim are those heavenly forces that maintain harmony and balance in the universe. They are also those messenger angels of God who speak to people. Netzach is a seventh Sephirah. Netzach means victory, eternity, or vitality, because Netzach is a source of victorious inspiration. Netzach is the principle of creative artistic thinking. The archangel of Netzach is Chaniel. This means grace of God, or my grace is God. Chaniel inspires aesthetics and artistic talent. He is the bestower of charisma and is thus considered the founder of friendship and love between people. The angelic choir of Netzach are the Elohim, this means gods. These angelic beings may be compared to the lower gods of other mystery traditions, such as with the graces or muses of the Greek and Roman traditions, which inspire people to beauty and art. Hod is the eighth Sephirah. Hod means glory or splendor, because Hod gives an outer shape to victory. Hod is the principle of logical analytical thinking. The archangel of Hod is Michael, whose name means who is like God. It is said that Michael overcame Samael, or Satan, and his followers with this analytical battle cry, and thus put them in their place during their rebellion. The host of angels of Hod are the Beni Elohim, this means sons of the gods. These spiritualized beings of the inner planes are comparable to the cultural founders, the deified teachers, or the demigods of other traditions, such as Prometheus, Chiron, and Hercules in Greek mythology. Yesod is the ninth Sephirah. Yesod means foundation, basis, or substructure, for Yesod is the astral matrix of the material world. Yesod is the principle of the collective subconscious. The archangel of Yesod is Gabriel. He is also known by his anglicized name Gabriel. His name means Mighty One of God, or My Power is God, or My Hero is God. Gabriel proclaims the will of God to men through visions or dreams. He is also considered as the angel who brings the unborn souls to the womb. The angelic host of Yesod are the Cherubim. This means the Blessing Ones. This angelic host shape the material world by bringing the higher blessing into manifestation. Malchut is the 10th Sephirah. Malchut means kingdom, because Malchut is the principle of manifestation in the material world. The archangel of Malchut is Sandalphon. According to tradition, Sandalphon is the prophet Elijah who has been transformed into an archangel. Since the prophet Elijah was a human being once and knows the material plane well, he is the archangel of Malchut. There are many narratives about him as an angel in human form who gives help and support to people in need. The angelic host of Malchut are the Ishim. In the Kabbalah, the Ishim are those humans who have attained salvation or holiness and are liberated from the cycle of rebirth. Simply put, they are those people who have learned everything in the world of form and now serve the light and act as a source of inspiration as spiritualized teachers from the inner planes. This was our overview of the meanings of the archangels and the hosts of angels on the Tree of Life. Perhaps you are now looking forward to the promised practical applications of these assignments? Here they are. Refuah, as taught by Salomo Baal Shem, is our first practical application of the spiritual powers of the Sephirot and the work with angels. In Refuah, you will receive, amongst other things, a deep access to the harmonizing power of the Archangel Raphael. You will also learn to get in touch with other archangels while in a meditative state, in order to gain a deeper understanding of your life and find solutions for any of your life situations or essential questions. A second practical application is the work with talismans and amulets, which is also a part of Refuah as taught by Salomo Baal Shem. Here, the powers of the archangels are called to support an intention, for instance a healing, in accordance with the divine will. If you want to know more about Refuah, then visit our Refuah homepage, our Refuah seminars, and watch the forthcoming video on spiritual healing and Refuah as taught by Salomo Baal Shem here on our YouTube channel. Learn more about the way talismans and amulets work and how they are made properly in a corresponding video, which will be available soon on this channel. For a complete overview of the principles described here and other valuable information, visit our interactive Tree of Life on our website, link in the description. If you want to learn more about practical spiritual work and magic, watch out for our regular workshops. Visit our free online courses and forums to access valuable theoretical knowledge and numerous resources, as well as exchange with like-minded people. All relevant links can be found here in the description. Tell us right after the video which angel or which Sephiroth particularly appeals to you. You may also be interested in learning from scratch how to interact with angels and enrich your life in doing so. Let us know and tell us in the comments. If you enjoyed our video, support us with your like. You are new here? Then subscribe to our channel now so that you won't miss any of our videos. That's it for this topic. Stay tuned and see you soon in the next video.